Hello everyone, AG47 Recon here. Well, I finally did it. I took the plunge. I actually took the plunge months ago, but eventually I didn't have to do anything about it. I just put this special thing away. This is going to be the heaviest silver in my collection. The problem is when I got it, it came in and the outside plastic was damaged. But it still had an internal plastic to protect it. So what I'm talking about is my first 1 kilo Geiger. Saved enough money and I was able to get one of these. Problem is my OCD kicked in and this thing is not protected properly, because it's, even though it still has the innermost plastic, the outermost plastic has been damaged from the transport, because it just got jiggled around inside the box during transport. And because this is so heavy, it damaged the plastic from within inside the box. So this has been sitting like forever in my safe. Then I heard about psychedelic silver. Psychedelic silver makes acrylic holders for large Geigers like these. And I think it goes up to a kilo if I remember. So I talked to him and we made arrangement. And just to give you an overview what it looks like. So this is a Geiger in an assay. He kind of replicates this holder, but in a much bigger form. So with that said, I wanted to get the Geiger look on it, but what my plan was is to just have it like free floating inside the acrylic. So I special requested a acrylic holder without the Geiger backing this white field around it. So with that said, it came in and I'm finally gonna put it in. So here's the set, there's the acrylic, and there's the actual cutout for the Geiger. And this part is the back, according to his instructions. There's the screws, and then I can just screw it in. And then we will get this Geiger into this acrylic and finally might be able to display it or just keep it safe in the safe. All right, I'm gonna time lapse my installation so you guys don't have to go watch the whole process. I'm gonna turn off this light so you guys don't see the glare, and we will begin. Okay, wow, he actually made this very tight tolerances because the plastic is preventing it from getting in there. But I bet you if I take the plastic off, this and protected plastic, it will fit. So I'm in a bind right now. So if I don't know if I want to take the plastic off or go ahead and proceed, but we will try to some more. And then if not, we'll take plastic off. Well, made it. That is pretty tight tolerances. Good job, Psychedelic Silver. That is very tight tolerances on that one. So, let's put it back together. So it goes like that. And now, it's time to put the back. So I was able to preserve the plastic that goes in there, but that is really good engineering right there. And I appreciate that quality of work. So should it go this way? Let me double check. Let's peel this off and let's figure it out. Ooh, that's satisfying. Alright. So I'm wearing gloves. I didn't want to put all my fingerprints in here. Let's just double check if I put any fingerprints on the internal side. Let's take that out again. There's a few fingerprints in there. Let's go ahead and clean it up some more. And I got my microfiber. Let's clean out the fingerprints from that side. And on the Geiger itself. And on the internal side of the holder. Make sure there's no dust or anything. And let's go ahead and assemble it. I'm putting the back portion. And let's figure out what's the correct position here. I bet you had tight tolerances on this one too. So we will see. And it looks like that's the correct position. Let's wipe that down. We don't have anything on the inside. And let's go ahead and grab the screws. Apologize for the bright light on the top. Can't help it with these shiny acrylics or coins. Here, what is going on here? Let's go ahead and cut the plastic. It's a Ziploc, didn't want to open. Put that away. Alright, let's do this. So let's go ahead and screw this in. Or is it just a push in? I think it's just a push in. No, it's screwed in. All right, so that's one. It's actually a push in. Kind of deceiving because there's some screws on there, screw threads. So it's just a push in and then it'll seal itself up. And looks like we are done. Put the last parts out of here. And there you go. It's a free floating 1 kilo Geiger in the acrylic, courtesy of Psychedelic Silver. And this is what it's supposed to look like with the white border on it, but I kind of like it free floating like this. Psychedelic, you do some great work. Appreciate making a deal with me on this acrylic without the white border. And this will be safely stored in the safe and protected. And then sometimes I can probably display it if I need to. Again, Psychedelic, thank you. Do some fine work here. Guys, thank you for all the support and the love. Please stay positive and have a great day. This one is one of the first ones that I did, well, when I personally first saw Wild Pig Pours. the coin show. So this is one that I bought. I follow him on Instagram and I finally met him in person. And this is the one I bought that he signed pig on it. Since he doesn't do COA, this is a full 2 ounces Wild Pig Force with the American flag, stars and stripes, America to the bone. So this will be a bin of $80, 2 ounces. Okay, this one is Bunker Bullion. It has some instructions on how to keep it and maintain the appearance of the marbleized bar. So this is from Bunker Bullion. This is 100 grams back in 2021. This is the marbleized silver. He has a process to make it look like it's marble. I put it in this case. This will be a bin of 120. Bin 120 on this one. This is a 1990 Australian Kookaburra, first year of the Kooks, still in the government issued capsule. This is the capsule that it comes in, and it has a bit of a toning on the edge over here where the cook is, but on the queen side it is nice. So this will be a bin of 45.